This is continuous time I am taking, h1 of t, h2 of t. I am taking a problem in properties of impulse response. I am taking a problem in properties of impulse response. So three blocks are in parallel. Three blocks are in parallel, h1, h2, h3. Then I will add these two blocks. I am giving the same input for all the three blocks. X of t. And after H1, I will put H4. And here is the final output addition again. So one more time, I am going to add. And after this, I am going to put H5. And here comes final output y of t. Find y of t. This is the question. I am going with the solution based on the properties of h of t. If two blocks are in parallel, we have to add them. If they are in series, we have to make convolution between them. So what I will do, h1 of t, h4 of t, they are in series. So convolution between them, and then h2 of t and h3 of t, they are in parallel. So addition between them. Then comes this summation point. After the summation point, h5 of t is there, h5 of t. And then after h5, it is y of t. And these two blocks are getting, equivalent blocks are getting added. Our overall input is x of t now. Already given is x of t. And only two blocks are left out. In the place of four blocks, I have converted into two blocks. Now these blocks are in parallel. So what I have to do, I have to add them. H1 of t, convolution, h4 of t is the first block. Then addition with h2 of t plus h3 of t. These are my two blocks in parallel. I have to add them. And after this, the summation point. After summation point, it is h5 of t. Y of t, overall output. X of t, overall input. Okay. So now if you see, output is nothing. And this can be further made into a single block. Okay. And that single block is nothing but convolution of H5. Okay. Convolution of H5 with this complete. Okay. So I will take flower bracket, H1 of t, convolution, H4 of t, first term. Second term is H2 of t plus H3 of t. This is second term, and this complete I am putting in flower bracket, convolution with H5. I am converting two blocks to a single block. Overall output is y of t, overall input is x of t. Okay. Now final output y of t, in any block, output is convolution of input and impulse response. Okay. This complete is the impulse response now. This complete block is the system or impulse response, system behavior. Okay. System characteristics, everything is this complete block, whatever present inside this complete block. So output is nothing but convolution of input and impulse response. Okay. So what I will do, I have to take the complete thing, whatever present inside the block. So H5 of t, then convolution. I have a flower bracket. Then first term is H1 of t, convolution, H4 of t. And then this is the first term. Second term is H2 of t plus H3 of t. Here the flower bracket closes, and also one more normal bracket I have to close because I have taken before H5 on normal open bracket, so that open bracket will be closed. This is the final output y of t. Okay, this is the final output y of t. Now I will go with, this is a problem on properties of impulse response. Now I will go with what is step response and what is impulse response. Okay, what is the meaning of impulse response and step response? What is the meaning of impulse response and step response? Okay, so first of all, we know impulse signal and step signal. Impulse signal means del of n. Step signal means u of n. In continuous time, it is u of t. In continuous time, it is del of t. Okay, discrete time, continuous time representation. Discrete time, continuous time representation. Now, impulse response means I will take a system. System behavior is h of n or h of t. Input is x of n or x of t. Output is y of n or y of t. Okay, continuous discrete time means you have to write n. Continuous time means you have to put t. Okay, and if input is impulse signal, output is called impulse response. Okay, input equal to impulse, input is impulse signal, output is called impulse response. Output is called impulse response. Okay, and if you take similarly the same system, if you take one more time the same system, I will put it as h of n, x of n, y of n, x of n, y of n. If input is step signal, output is called step response. Input is step signal, output is called, name of the output is step response. Name of the output is step response. Okay, the same system, what we can do in continuous time, the same system can also be represented as the same system. I will take, so in order to give some clear picture. So if it is continuous time, you will be using h of t, x of t, y of t. If it is continuous time, you will use h of t, x of t, y of t is the representation. Discrete time means small letter n, continuous time means small letter t. Okay, this is the meaning. So already we know that impulse signal means, okay, impulse signal del of n or del of t, it has height only at origin. Okay, it has some height only at origin. This is called del of n. Step signal u of n means only positive side from origin, only positive side. It will have pillars up to infinity. Negative side no heights. This is step signal. And u of t means it is a continuous representation. This is u of t. Okay, u of n means discrete time, u of t means continuous time. This is discrete time step signal, this is continuous time step signal. Okay, this is also step signal, this is also called step signal. Okay, in continuous time, in discrete time. Similarly, del of t also, it will have height only at origin. Del of t also, it will have height only at origin. Okay, it is t, and this is the signal in continuous time, this is the signal in discrete time, this is the signal in discrete time. Left side I have written what is the meaning of impulse response and step response. Right side I have given some basic details. Left side I have told what is impulse response and step response. Okay, and if the input is step signal, output is called step response. If the input is impulse signal, output is called impulse response. If the input is impulse, output is impulse response. Input is step means output is step response.